This seems like a nice place for a barbecue.
What? The dude's on fire!
Oceanhorn 2, Knights of the Lost Realm, is a fairly popular game, but I never played it. But now with the release of the 4.0 version, it seemed like a good opportunity to get started. The game is obviously very similar to The Legend of Zelda, The Breath of the Wild. It reminds me of the meme, "Mom, can we get Zelda?" To which she replies,
"We have Zelda at home."
So, is this game Discount Zelda? I don't know about that, as I don't have a Nintendo Switch, but I do know that I like this game, so far. Look at the graphics, that's really good for a game on Apple Arcade. Although it was one of the launch titles, that's when most of the best games on the service were launched. Anyway, this game seems fun. That's why I'm starting the quest from the beginning. Right away, I'm going to let you know that the controls, they seem good. I did see people mentioning a problem with the controls, but it seems really smooth to me. Perhaps that's related to version 4.0. As the update notes say, control responsiveness has been improved across the board. It feels pretty good. It's your standard left thumbstick to move around, and a right thumbstick to look around. That bird flew pretty close. It reminds me of a McDonald's parking lot not too far from me. The seagulls will walk right up to your car and stare you down until you give them french fries. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah, the controls. The buttons, they do stuff. Perhaps it's my setup too, as I'm playing with a SteelSeries Nimbus Plus on an Apple TV. I think he's going to need a lawnmower, because that sword is not cutting it. Will he die if I walk off this cliff? No, he's okay. The water is not too bad. Oh wow, he swims. It looks like he has a stamina bar. I should get him back on land before that runs out. Nice, he's back on dry ground. It looks like he's got a gun along with his sword. There are also these little indicators on what to do next, like reading this book. That was a quick read. But basically there's a mini-map at the top right that lets you know where to go. Did you hear that? The sounds of the footsteps changed when walking over the wooden planks. Nice. The developers did their homework. What's also nice is that this is essentially the tutorial, but it doesn't feel like a generic tutorial. From the very first moment, you're able to look around, explore, and fight monsters, like whatever that thing was back there. I mean, let's be real, alright? If you see a bug in the bathroom at like 3 a.m., and it's tiny in comparison, but it's still super creepy. So if I see something big like that on the street, I'm gonna run away. And I'm not getting on a ladder like that. Just look at it. That's super high. Oh well, maybe I would use it if I was trying to run away from whatever that green thing was in the cutscene. That's a tough call though. I'm just saying, you don't appreciate the true difficulty here. Just because some spiky-haired kid is doing the heavy lifting, even the mundane tasks are the actions of a hero. Or maybe the actions of a gym jock. I lift things up and puts them down. Up. Down. Now, don't get me wrong. It's not that I'm insulting hard work. I respect exercise and body development. I just like the old commercial. But what I don't like is how this guy can't climb or jump. Unless he's standing in the right spot. So a big part of the game's difficulty is finding the right place to be. Dude, there's a chest right there! Go get it! Rise, my friend! Climb! You can do it! Instead, I have to play Jenga on these crates over here. The guy can climb a mile-high ladder, but he can't go over these little rocks. This is exactly why I didn't like Zelda on the Nintendo 64. That and the stupid, unskippable owl. That's it. I'm going to take out my frustration on some plant life. Ah, there he goes. Now he's a circus performer. More flips than a gymnastics event at the Olympics. So, what's in the chest? An owl? And it's an owl. Decades later, I'm still having trouble with these things. And what am I supposed to do with this thing? Stupid. This early stage loot is highly dubious, as I got that and the smallest shield known to man. What is that? A dinner plate? But apparently, it's useful for moving large boulders. It's nice that the game has helpful messages, as I don't think that I would quickly realize that such a tiny shield is what's needed to move such a humongous rock. Anyway, now we must be at the mall, as there's a wide selection of pots to choose from. The sign said that the pots could be thrown, but all they do is roll off his spiky head. Let's run around in circles while we figure this out. Cute. He got tired. Stupid pot. Oh, there's a button here. Now that makes sense. I'll just pick up one of these pots and put it on the button. Well, that solves that puzzle. Now the doorway is open. Oh, it's another cutscene. More bugs. Run! Mom, there's a bug in the bathroom! Actually, those are three bugs. It seems the hero is outnumbered. Oh, wait! He has a gun! Just shoot them! Ready, aim, fire! Hero uses gun. It is not very effective. This guy has one of the weakest guns around. It took five bullets to take out one bug. There's a clear argument to protect the Second Amendment. Ammo caps hinder the right to self-defense. He should be able to chop up the other two with his sword. Ha! He was trying to run. See? No problem. And the reward is... a key. In a chest with a lock, there was a key. You know, if this guy watched a few episodes of The Lockpicking Lawyer, perhaps we could speedrun this level. Hey, what's this on the ground? It looks like I can pick it up. Health. That's nice. It looks like I missed some bonuses back there. Here's another fight. No problem. I'll just use my mighty shield. Hey, it worked. I'll try that again. The bug jumped right over it. That's pointless. Oh wait, the health was the same. It looks like the shield is not so bad. There's the gate. The key should open that. But somehow there's a boulder on the other side. Pretty intricate security in this place. Looks like this is another job for the shield. I'll just push the boulder out of the way. Oh, it looks like I missed those bugs down there. Looks like I'll have to do this the old-fashioned way. Don't try it, Anakin! I have the high ground! It's nice that I could work some prequel memes into this video. Over here, we have an unattended fire. Do you have any idea how dangerous that is? Do you have any idea how expensive that is? With high gas prices and the war in Ukraine, heating costs are really high. I might as well take advantage of it, as this seems like a nice place for a barbecue. What? The dude's on fire! How are you not dead? Your entire body was engulfed in flame. I think that one's too big for you to pick up, buddy. Keep the barrels away from the torches. They can catch fire easily. The problem is that our friend here also catches fire easily. But now this area is starting to make sense. The idea is to set the barricade on fire. I'll try to be more gentle and careful with the flame this time. Hot, hot, hot. It's strange. He didn't get set on fire this time. Oh well, it's pretty obvious what to do next now. And level up. He's level 2 now. I don't know if that's good or bad, but mathematically, 2 is 100% more than 1. That lantern seems useful. I wonder if he can pick it up. Dude, just lift up your arms. It's right there. Maybe I can jump up there. Not that time. There we go. And he's not going to pick it up, is he? He's just going to stand on it instead. He's really close to that book. Does he have a vision problem? Maybe I can help him out. There. I increased the size of the interface. Nice. A secret harbor, because the best way to keep a harbor a secret is to put a sign right out in front. Well, this does seem to be the right way to go. Huh? What's that? That looks different. Ah, it appears to be an explosive. I wonder if I can shoot it. Yup. But that didn't do much. Not unless you're into collecting achievements. I think that's what they mean by the secret harbor. It looks nice. But you'd think a covered dock would have done a better job of protecting that ship. Well, this is where we can answer an important question. What happens when the stamina runs out? How long can the hero keep swimming after the stamina hits zero? Whoa! Not long at all. The guy can sustain fire damage like he was made of tungsten, but he immediately collapses if he stays in the water longer than a few seconds? At least the game is generous with the save locations. Moving on. Or not. I didn't mean to jump on the side of the wall like that. Can I make it back? Nope. Looks like he fell back to an earlier part of this level. That's not the end of the world. With a little walking, the pirate treasure room is now available. It's very nice of the hero to help out with the gardening. Chop those weeds. Well, that's a lot of water over there. I don't want to see this guy drown again. So, I'm going to carefully scan the area first. It looks like there are some explosives out there. I'll try shooting them. What? I keep missing. Wow, does this game know that bullets arc when you shoot them? In that case, I'll have to aim higher. Well, I hit them, but now I'm out of bullets, and that didn't seem to do anything. I guess I'll try swimming around. Huh, a cutscene. The good news is that this water is not deep. The bad news is that the hero is now trapped in here. The other bad news is that there's some angry octopus monster in here. He's well out of range, so I should be safe over here. Or not. That's not fair, he's throwing stuff at me. It appears to be free health, so not really a threat. Yet, how am I going to stop this guy? Can I shoot him? Nope. Perhaps I'm overthinking this. I should just go right at him. Yup, just hit those purple things. Doing enough of that reveals the weak spot of the head. That's not very pretty. Yuck, it's even worse when it explodes. Well, that ends the starter quest. What do you think? Do you like this game? Also, do you want to see me keep playing this game? You can let everyone know in the comments. Thanks for watching.